Welcome back, everybody. This is episode 11 of Abame's Monster Adventure, and off-camera I've been tidying up the base a little bit, removing the ME cables and replacing it with ME conduits, so you can see that we do have quite a lot of stuff going on. But it's looking a lot neater than it was. So that's, yeah, so where I had ME cables going across all the roof and all that kind of stuff, I've replaced them all. And up there is a lot neater as well. Let's go and have a look. So now it's the ME cable or ME conduit connects just into there. No, that's not right. We'll replace that later. And same for the back here. I've also set up these barrels to contain some of the tree farm items. Haven't done anything else with the farm. I've also got ME cable running across to here, and this is what we're going to be working on today. Let's see, is the sign correct? IC2 and rotary craft machines. I'm going to get on with some IC2 stuff. As I said before, we're wanting to get on with making some power armour. And to do that, some IC2 machines is going to help, and it's been a while since I've looked at IC2, so I'm quite excited about the changes, and maybe I might find it a little bit annoying after a little while. Let's see. So, looking up, industrial craft, so the first thing we want is a generator. It's just going to allow us to process our ores, or process, well, process coal into IC2 energy. So we are going to need one of these forge hammers by the looks of it to get us started. The other way to make this is with the metal former in a mode of rolling. And that's really what we're going to be looking to get up and running today. So a system where we can automate the crafting of iron plates, or plates, and the cables. Okay, so first of all, yeah, let's get one of those hammers. I could also just use iron plates, so rather than one iron plus the hammer, I could just use the 4 iron, and that's from Calclavia core. I'm not going to use those. I want to see what ICT is all about after the changes. Let's go and head upstairs for this. So we've got a hammer. And we're going to need a few of these. I'm going to just grab out 12 to start with, see how we get on with that. See, what else do we need? So we need one of these batteries. Well, that's handy, the NEI stuff has sorted itself out on that. Previously we would have needed to find the empty battery in the recipe list. Okay, so that's tin plate is needed as well. Where's the hammer? I wonder why that didn't get placed in there when I was... Let's just grab out a few of these. And then we also need to have 4 of them for a battery. Right then. Insulated tin cable, and tin cables made with tin and cutter, so we don't have one of those yet. Let's plug that in. Ah, now starting to get into things that we should really be looking to automate or build up the recipes for. So this thing here, Oh, this one. We just place that in. We know how to craft that rubber bar. So let's get that placed in. And what else do we need? So we don't know how to craft those at the moment, but that's going to be going into the rolling machine. So we're not going to look to automate that immediately, but we do need one of these. Now, do I really have iron plates in the system? No, I don't. So let's grab some of these out. Just want to make sure I'm using the right recipe. Got an iron furnace. Might be a good time to program in a standard furnace with cobblestone as well. And we're going to want, was I just thinking? Oh yeah, we need some more blank patterns. Okay, so how are we doing? Generator, so the battery, we can program this recipe in for crafting. That's why it's taking a little while to come through. Generator, so we have the iron furnace, we've got the battery. Just waiting to see if this goes to all those types of iron plates. Maybe it won't. Let's try and pull out a generator. Now that could be a problem with the way we set up that generator recipe. Let's try and pull out one of these batteries. Did it complete it? It did. Okay, so yeah, that recipe may well be incorrect. Let's just pull out the generator. And just place that battery in there. And see if that sorts it out for us. Right, not sure what's going on. I'm gonna train. Well, let's cancel that first of all. Try and create another one. Okay, well that worked fine. That battery obviously in that recipe was incorrect, whatever the difference was. Okay, so we're just going to place the generator here. Next up I want a battery, or a battery box, to store the energy. I suspect some of that we can encode down here. So where's the battery box? That's the bat box. So we need some more insulated tin cable, standard wood, and quite a few of these batteries. Okay, well I'm gonna get on with programming in a battery box and grab one out, and I shall see you once that's done. Okay, we have a battery box. Just going to place that there. Left a little bit of space here. I'm thinking I might go for an MFE very shortly, and then I'll need a low voltage transformer to convert it down to the power level we'll be using, and that's going to allow me to just cook up coal and store energy for when we need it. Okay, so next up, I'm going to want some, I might as well go for some fibre optic cable. That'll save us having to worry about power, or what power level we can fit through cables later on. So that's glass. Now this is pulverized silver. Yes, we're not storing silver in the pulverized form. So we'll have to pulverize some silver, but then it'll try and cook it up. We'll try and figure this out. So this is all new, diamond dust and redstone. Let's just program that in. We're already on page 2. Oh, I've got the wrong one there. That's thermal expansion, let's just use that. Okay, so I'm going to have to teach system how to pulverize silver too. Right, we can do it with this thermal expansion. That's going to try and cook it up immediately. Right, let's try and grab that out. Right, to create this fibre we need some of this diamond dust, and that diamond dust is only available through a macerator, so yeah, we need some copper cable as well for the time being to be able to run power from that through that into a macerator that's going to sit here temporarily until we can get the fibre optic cable and then remove the copper cable. So I'm going to get on with building a macerator. Don't think there's that much that's changed between the previous version and this in terms of macerators. Okay, so some electronic circuit and basic machine, so we know how to create all that stuff. I'll get off and make that. I'll be right back with you. Okay, so we've got some copper cable on the macerator. I'm just going to connect. Oops. Right, and the macerator is just going to sit here. You see that we've got all this is the applied energistics network coming out to here. Okay, well, let's macerate down one of these. Okay, so let's start hooking in the applied energistics network to ICT machines. First thing we're going to do is teach it about this. Ooh, I need to go off mining nether quartz in my mining age. Okay, I'm just going to place this ME interface beside my macerator and tell it how to make the diamonds. So now the system will export the diamonds over to here, then it needs to craft. Now we're doing for energy. Just keep an eye on this for the time being It's not a permanent solution to my energy generation by any means. It's just something to get us up and running. I'm really just looking to run some rolling machines at the moment for IC2, but at some stage we'll upgrade the power and all the machines to get them working top notch, because we can get them working faster than the so the mass rate we can upgrade to work faster than the pulverizer, for example. So it's likely that we'll start to upgrade those machines over there at some point. Okay, well, let's finish this off. So let's stick an import bus on top. So do we have fiber optic cable yet? No, what's happened? It's cooking up some glass. Okay, I've decided just to move this machine here. We want that, the generator. I'm just going to sit it beside this until we get a more permanent power structure. I'm not going to create my MFE at the moment. And we have our fibre optic cable now, so I'm just going to run this underneath the machines. So that's going to save us having to rewire underneath the machines if we upgrade the power source at some point. Okay, next up I'm wanting to look at rolling machines. This is going to allow us then to expand into further IC2 stuff, so this is pretty much getting the basics up and running. And it's not a rolling machine. Let's have a look at this. So yeah, a metal former is what we're looking for. I'm going to want two of these. One of them for creating the plates, and one of them for creating wires. And that's going to allow us then to set up recipes, and we'll be able to automate everything else to do with the creation of those items for IC2. Okay, that's not the right one we want to use. Right, that's what we want to use. Now we already know how to make that and that. This thing is new. I probably don't know how to make chests yet. Oh no, we do, that's fine. Let's see, what else do we need? Bronze item casing, that's another thing that's going to go in the same machine that's going to create the plates. If we have a look at that, so the rolling machine, the metal former in rolling mode, will convert the bronze plates into the bronze item casing. And if we have a look at the bronze plate, that's made with the mode rolling as well. So the same machine can do both operations. Okay, so what else do we need? Some of this stuff. Yeah, let's try and grab one of those out. It's not going to complete. In fact, we can place all the copper wires back in there now. Right, so I'm going to have to create the plates and the copper wires for this until we get a little bit further along the road of metal forming. So what's it need? Five. Is that bronze or? Oh, it's bronze item casing. I don't think that's going to be enough. Yeah, we need one more, so let's get another bit of bronze out. And what else? Copper wires. And it needs nine of them. some copper plates we can use here. So it needs some more. Okay, I'm going to just slowly work my way through what it needs, and we'll be back once we've got a metal former. Okay, we have the metal former. I'm just going to place this down beside the other machines. Now we want this in rolling mode. We're going to get plates made with this, and we're going to have to teach it the recipes. So copper, bronze, all those ones that we've seen, as well as the plates. So I'm going to get on with telling the system how to create a few items, and I'll be back with you in a bit. Okay, we've got the final former here. Let's place that down, and this one we want to have in extruding mode. That's going to be for the wires. And I've set up two, so I'm just using the ingots into the cables. And here's what we've set up in this machine here, and that's running in former mode, or in rolling mode. Okay, so that's pretty cool. We've got everything set up the way we would want it to be. We don't need to use that or that ever again. We've got those machines to do the jobs for us now. So let's have a look at the not force. That's modular power suits. Yeah. So each of these contain two electronic circuits, and now we know how to create all the components for those. So we're just going to get a system to create us 8 of those. And I think that'll do for this episode. Next episode, we'll be looking into using these and plugging in upgrades to them. So thank you all for watching, and I shall see you next time.